I say no.
Did you eat?
I say no.
Wanna leave?
Oh no.
Better me?
Fuck no.
Did you eat?
I say no.
How'd you sleep?
Oh no.
You want that shit that's slowly killing you? Well, how could I say no? Buying records when the rents due with several different copies of Lebowski. Every cover art is sloppy, but I really love the Blu-ray package. And about the Frankenstein of one of one. Did you say 3 for 1? I'll buy the section like a rapper. I got original trilogy, many mediums, pre and post special edition, and true completionist. Cheaper most scenarios, except for copper vintage Bulls pieces and 2005 ALCS Sox tees, a tchotchke, and they'll keep my feelings at bay. And a pocket full of bunnies like the mint condition Playboy pins I snagged from Best Garage Sale up at Albany Park. I gotta keep them shelves fuller, it will always be dark. Albeit if I never would've got these, I'd be farther than the hem of a tall tee from a logo 7 squatchy. Gosh, I know you wish that you could stop me. Wash. One day I'll find the perfect thing and stop these thoughts. Then maybe I'll say no, 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 no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no. You've been saving.
I say no.
Car no.
Hell no.
Traffic tickets.
What you think?
You gon' make it?
I don't know.
Car insurance?
Yeah, okay.
Health insurance?
I'm okay.
Credit card?
In your dreams.
Grocery shop?
Uber Eats, motherfucker. Many facets of a glutton. I can't taste what I can't stomach. I can't ache, then I can't function. I can't make, then I can't love. And I can't wait till I'm above it all. Making that whatever assumption, but it's a multi-pronged. However many entendre, not religious. If I was, maybe I'd have a reason to stop or keep running that full tilt. Guilt for breakfast, be bulimic. Shadow keep me emetophobic. Scratch the message into the bottom of the nook in the corner of your mansion, where the sun illuminates the floating dust. The invocation of a cancer I can't run. In the sludge be the sum of the scum. I'm the son of a survivor, find itself so engulfed in the workings of the unruly. I can't be no more. Is it shame, the restraint? I'd like to think I'm in control. Know what it's like to not be able to retreat in your own home. What it's like for your own mind to pit itself against your whole being. I wish I could draw it out, but I can't promise photorealism. I just hope that you could feel me in any way. Days of silent penance explain the absence of essence. Lately, I'll try to fill you in every day. Best wishes from the desk at 808 anyway.
Drugs and entertainment is escape, yes, from my problems and my life and having to be stuck in here. I can, you know, pretend I'm James Bond or pretend so. It just it seems fine over the short haul. As a way of life, it doesn't work all that well, though. No, it seems to me to be, and this isn't a very original thing to say. It's a pretty natural extension of corporate capitalist logic, which is, I want to feel exactly the way I want to feel, which is good, for exactly this long, and so I will exchange a certain amount of cash for this substance, and I will do it. But it's all of course a lie, because the control gradually goes away, and it stops being that I want to do it, and becomes that I feel I need to do it. And that shift from I want something to I feel I need it is a big one. Yes, I mean. Most of the problems in my life have to do with my confusing what I want and what I need.